So you're ready to do your planning in SAP Analytics Cloud and wondering where to begin. Well, the first thing you're going to need is a planning model, and chances are you'll want to start from a blank model, which gives you maximum flexibility to define all your accounts and dimensions from scratch. Dimensions for version and date are created automatically. Right now, there's just a single version to hold your actuals data, but when your model is complete, you can add other versions by importing or entering data for other planning categories like budget or forecast. End dates are key for planning, so you can choose the time granularity, which means the smallest unit of time, as well as the time hierarchy for your model. You can also configure your preferences for additional date and time options, like setting up a fiscal year that doesn't match the calendar year, choosing the time range you want to work with, and selecting a default currency and enabling currency conversion in stories based on the model. Create an account dimension to contain all your accounts and measures. Here in the list view, you can add your account members one by one. Each member needs an ID, which is usually the account number, and a description, which is the name or purpose of the account. You can build a hierarchy of your accounts by specifying the parent account for each member all the way up to the root level. If your structure is mapped out already, you can copy and paste it into the columns of the grid view. There are lots of options for customizing the attributes of your accounts, but a few key ones are formula, where you can define how to calculate values based on other accounts, account type, where you can classify accounts as income, expense, asset, liability and equity, or non-financial, aggregation type, where you can define how values are calculated from the leaf nodes, and threshold, where you can define ranges that classify values as OK, warning, or critical to change how they display in stories. Create an organization dimension, such as region, to define how your organization is structured. Add the IDs and descriptions for any members. Define any hierarchical relationships. Enter the currency in which you'll either import or enter the values for each member, and specify the user to which any input task will be assigned. And create generic dimensions for any other relevant ways of dividing or aggregating values, such as product information, with any parent-child relationships. Once your dimensions are created, you can save your model. Success! And now that the model is complete, it's ready for data to be added to it. For more details on what you can do with models, check out the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.